Spina bifida is a neural tube defect. Now, what that means in simple terms is that during the first 12 weeks of gestation, when all of the bits of your body come together and are fully formed, the spine ends up either being slightly open or bits aren't plugged in properly, which can leave you with some neurological defects further down the line. Now, depending on whereabouts on the spine it is will dictate which bits are affected. And obviously, further up, you're going to get effects further up on the body, whereas lower down, you may well get things which affect it lower down. Now, spina bifida is a continuum. Now, what I mean by that is that on one end, you have people who may not even know they've got spina bifida. Or if they do, it's something which was found incidentally as part of a screening or a scan or an X-ray. On the other side of the continuum, you've got people who've got significant physical difficulties, possibly hydrocephalus as well. May not be able to walk, maybe in wheelchairs, maybe incontinent. So there's quite a difference between the two sides. Now, I sit somewhere about here. I've had surgery on my spine. I've had surgery for a club foot, which I'll talk about later on. So it's something which I know about and have known about pretty much all of my life. But I still consider myself to be particularly lucky. Spina bifida is a really, really interesting subject. Statistically, 1,500 to 2,000 babies are born each year in the US with spina bifida. I haven't got any UK figures. I'm going to try and find some of those out before the end of the week. But what I have done in the text of this post, I have put a link through to SHINE, which is the Spina Bifida Hydrocephalus Information Networking and Education site, which is part of the yellow banner at the top, to give you more information about spina bifida. Now, as always, if you've got any comments, if you've got any questions, stick them below and I'll catch you guys later. Bye-bye.